Welcome to War India News Hour. Digital transformation is the key for a better future. Times have changed and so has the business landscape across segments in India. Organizations have realized the true potential of data and lately have accepted the fact that technological development is the key to their growth trajectory. Over the span of the past few months, the world has gone through phases wherein a ban on travel, restrictions on meeting people, visiting places of work have been imposed, and as a result, to maintain consistency, it has become imperative for organizations to digitally transform themselves. We have seen on the digital shift where the business disruptions and changing models of remote working have placed digital technology at the center of today's economic development debate. While there is no doubt that the pandemic is amplifying the adoption of new age technologies, however, the process has already started for some time now. Hence, the transformation became a little easy for some organizations and they rose on the occasion swiftly. They were able to achieve what would have normally taken many more years to accomplish. In fact, according to Dell Technologies Digital Transformation Index 2020, 94.7% of the businesses in India have fast-tracked at least some digital transformation programs this year. Truly, these unprecedented times have made business leaders realize that we are indeed stepping into an era which is powered by new age technologies and data which needs to be managed and secured digitally. The need of the hour is restructuring the IT infrastructure and workforce. Rejuvenating the IT architect has turned out to be the key to driving innovation, improving customer experiences, boosting reliability and security, and staying competitive. Restructuring of the workforce, upskilling and reskilling also need to be introduced as the new norm for businesses to stay competitive in this new normal. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. PM Modi to address the fourth edition of India Mobile Congress. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will deliver the inaugural address at the virtual India Mobile Congress, that is IMC 2020, on Tuesday. The fourth edition of IMC 2020 virtual event is going to accentuate the importance of the telecom sector. The event is being organized by the Department of Telecommunications, Government of India, and the Cellular Operators Association of India, that is COAI. It will be held from December 8th to 10th, 2020. McAfee report estimates global cybercrime losses to exceed $1 trillion. McAfee released a new global report titled The Hidden Costs of Cybercrime, which focuses on the significant financial and unseen impacts that cybercrime has worldwide. The report states that cybercrime costs the world economy more than $1 trillion, or just more than 1% of global GDP, which is up more than 50% from the 2018 study that put global losses at close to $600 billion. The report also explored the demand reported beyond financial losses, finding 92% of companies felt effects beyond monetary losses. Google Pay Phone Pay account for 86% of UPI transactions. As per the data from the National Payments Corporation of India, that is NPCI, published for the first time, Google Pay accounted for 857.81 million transactions, while Phone Pay came in second with 839.88 million transactions. Together, the two apps accounted for about 81% of the market. At the same time, Paytm accounted for about 11% of the market with 244.94 million transactions, that is 27,489.33 crores in value. Amazon Pay saw 46.59 million transactions, that is 3,854.49 in value. Reliance Jio to launch low-cost 4G Android smartphones. The low-cost 4G smartphones from Jio and Google was to debut in December. However, that isn't happening as the telco is now set to launch them in Q1 2021. As part of the partnership, both Jio and Google are looking to develop affordable 4G smartphones and even 5G smartphones. The launch is set to be delayed to Q1 2021 due to the ongoing supply chain issues. Mumbai-based startup EdTech Lead School acquires QuizNext. Mumbai-based EdTech startup Lead School has acquired Bengaluru's QuizNext, an AI-powered gamified student assessment and practice platform, for an undisclosed amount. Founded by Sumit Mehta and Smita Deora, Lead School claims to have partnered with over 800 schools across over 20 states in India. Lead School had raised $28 million in Series C funding led by Westridge Capital in August. Abu Dhabi Investment Office invests $41 million in Fresh2Home. Online raw meat retailer Fresh2Home Foods said that it will receive financial and non-financial incentives from the Abu Dhabi Investment Office, that is ADIO, to expand operations in the capital city of the United Arab Emirates. Fresh2Home, along with two other agritech companies, Pure Harvest and Nanorax, have won ADIO's partnership to receive a total of 152 million United Arab Emirates dirham, that is $41 million. Global manufacturing giant Foxconn hit by ransomware attack. Foxconn Electronics has suffered a ransomware attack around November 29, 2020 at their Foxconn CTBGMX facility located in Ciudad Juarez, Mexico facility over the Thanksgiving weekend, where the attackers had stolen unencrypted files before encrypting devices. The attackers have demanded $34 million ransom. The company has a recorded revenue of $172 million in 2019 and over 800,000 employees worldwide. Foxconn subsidiaries include Sharp Corporation, Innolux, FIH Mobile and Belkin. Now, the question is whether Foxconn will escape without giving this huge ransom or so-called bridge to the cyber hackers. Salesforce to acquire Acumen Solutions to enhance the reach. Salesforce has been heading towards industry focus for a number of years, both in terms of product, that is financial services cloud, health cloud, manufacturing cloud, consumer goods cloud, etc., and their professional services by encouraging third-party consulting partners to hone their client portfolios onto specific industries. To complement the efforts, Salesforce has signed an agreement to acquire Acumen Solutions. Acumen Solutions, a Salesforce top 10 partner with a 640-strong team of certified professionals, has been scooped up by Salesforce. With this acquisition, it will expand to the rest of the markets. It shows a clear threat to the competition with SAP. Apple to replace iPhone 11 display and address the touch issues. It will be a big relief to the owners of iPhone 11 as Apple has announced that it will replace the display on devices that have a glitchy touch screen for free owing to an issue with the display module. The iPhone 11 models affected by the issue were manufactured between November 2019 and May 2020. Apple has determined that a small percent of iPhone 11 displays may stop responding to touch due to an issue with the display module, the company said in an update on Friday. Steven Van Wyk is appointed as the Group CIO of HSBC. Van Wyk will lead the global team of HSBC full of technologists, and he will be responsible for ensuring the bank's business has strong technology capabilities so that they can deliver market-leading customer experiences. The news further states that AI and robotics are the two key technologies, while Van Wyk will also be in charge of operational resilience and manage the bank's cybersecurity. In order to ride the digital transformation wave successfully, it becomes imperative for organizations to consistently upskill their workforce. As per the Digital Transformation Index 2020 of Dell, it says 63.7% of respondents in India are investing in digital skills to transform their workforce and make them future ready. The report revealed that businesses are increasingly looking at investing towards emerging technologies like edge and AI/ML. In fact, 95% of the Indian respondents foresee using AI and data models to predict potential disruptions. The same report also states that out of the total respondents in India, 58.3% have completed their investment in cybersecurity and privacy. The internet and online services give us vast opportunities to share our views and connect with people around the world, and we need to make sure it is a safe place to express ourselves. Today, being an individual means being brave and bold with your opinions, and the task of safely expressing ourselves becomes a non-trivial one. Another report from Kaspersky Research says 37% of millennials think that they are too boring to ever be the victim of cybercrime. However, analysis of several darknet markets show that the data can be valuable not only for us but also for cybercriminals. Thus, among the most prized and desired data sold on these markets are selfies that are shared with documents such as passports or driver's license that is worth to $40 to $60, medical reports up to $30, credit card details up to $20, PayPal accounts up to $500, and full ID information up to $10. This information can be used for various malicious purposes, from using people's data to receive money to blackmail them. That's it for the day, but do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.